it's your boy. It's Speedy. It's 10 o'clock. Oh, shit. It's 7 o'clock on the west side, 10 on the east. You know what time it is. It's Speedy's Comedy Corner, and I'll be Speedy up in this biatch. It's Sirius Radio 106 XM 149. Yeah, the hottest show in on the land, on sea, all over. We are number one in Mars. On Mars, we are the number one show out there. So if you're in Mars, go ahead and check us out. Speedy's Comedy Corner. We've got a great show for you tonight. We're going to be talking about a lot of things. Write the number down first. 877-2106-106 is the number. Tour coming at you. Me and Jay Fizzy going on the road. First show July 4th and 3rd. In Vegas. So if you're in Vegas, 4th of July weekend, it's on and cracking. And then we start hitting all these other cities. So we can definitely shout out to you guys, the cities that we're coming to. Once again, write the number down. 877-2106-106 is the number. Speedy's Comedy Corner. Great show. We're talking about when is the honeymoon over as far as dating? You know, when does the cuteness wear off? When does that wear off? Usually for me is right after I hit pretty much you ain't that cute no more. Sorry to say that, ladies. That's just how it is. So I want the ladies even call in. Let us know, you know, at what point in the relationship does it really start to wear off for you that you're not excited to see that person no more, or they don't have to call you every 5 minutes no more. Matter of fact, let me call you. Take my number out your phone, and I'll call you. How about that? That makes it a lot easier. So we want to know. We want you to call in. Tell us that. When does it wear off? When is it not cool? For guys, I'm pretty sure after we hit, pretty much is downhill after that. If you try to wait and not want to give it to me, I'll find somebody that will. Write your name. 877-2106-106 is the number to call into. We got a great show for you. If you're going to Twitter, the address is Foxhole. Just go to Foxhole and you can see us on there. Throw your question on there and Shania answer that. We'll be right back. Take a quick break. Speedy's Comedy Corner, and I'll be Speedy up in this. Oh, we back. Speedy's Comedy Corner. And I'll be Speedy up in this. Yeah, we got a great show for you tonight. 877-2106-106 is the number to call in. Write that down. Put it in your little login book, whatever you got to do. So you can call in and talk about when is the honeymoon over in dating. Because sometimes you can be dating somebody and they do one thing wrong, and it's like, you got to go.
It's not you
blink your fries.
You know, you ain't cute no more.
Right.
You blinking again? Yeah. Is that what we're doing?
Is your nails growing? Bitch, get out of my house. So anything like that. In the house, Lou Deasy.
Hey, Speedy, how are you? Met your lovely daughter, Speedy? That's amazing. She is beautiful. Cheyenne
is
beautiful.
How you going to put my daughter on blast
on
the radio?
She's beautiful, Speedy. Look at you. She lucked up. Mommy, thank God.
Wow.
Wow. No, I'm really
good. Also in the house, Shanae is in the house. How you living, Shanae?
Good. Couple things. First off, we are on Twitter right now.
It's Twitter.
The
motherfuckers on Facebook are blowing you up about
it. I bet you can say dollar bill.
Ooh. I'm just joking. It's Twitter.
I'm not even going to go there. I'm going to finish my introduction very professionally. www.com.
www.com? What the fuck you think you're at the law office?
Speedy'scomedycorner.com. Our website is up now and functioning. You guys can go on.
We have to take that naked dude off there.
Yeah, I appreciate to all the dudes that sent me pictures. We wanted some girls to send in for Speedy and for Lewis Diggs that's looking for dates, and it seemed like only dudes responded, so I appreciate
that. Bitch.
Oh, well, that's how attractive I am.
Hold on.
You're the man in San Francisco.
I got to give my daughter a happy birthday shout out. She turned 10 on Sunday. Happy birthday, Naya.
Happy birthday, Naya. Happy birthday. What'd you get her?
We went to Six Flags Magic Mountain for her birthday.
Did you eat cake and stuff?
We did, and I'm sick.
Lewis, we got a show. Anyway, TDP's in the house.
AKA Buttercream Long Leg Mac Daddy right here on the scene. Let's do this, please.
Special guest is in the house. I like how you put that S on the special guest. It's my boy. We're doing a show this weekend at the Air Force Base in Travis. So the Air Force brothers out there, we're going to be out there Friday. My man, Mr. Ron G, is on the show.
Oh, it's me. All right, last game back.
We're driving up.
Yeah, we're coming back.
He's young, so we're going to be listening to old school all the way up. Sorry.
Who's car? I'm going to take a nap.
I want y'all to take Lewis' car.
Ain't no sunshine. I'm going to sleep. As soon as that part hit, I'm gone.
Give me your website. Somebody want to get in touch with you.
Oh, you can call me at my mama's house.
don't give your number out.
Okay, I'm just
I fucked around and gave my number out on accident, and niggas just called me like, hey, Speedy.
Hey, this you?
It's you, huh?
It's you, ain't it?
Hey, nigga, I love the show. Thought I'd let you know. Missed some other bitches you had on the show, but all right, cool, I'm out. And That's it. So don't get your number out.
So now it's Facebook. Hit me up on Facebook. It's Ron G, R-O-N-G-E-E. Or hit me up on myspace.com/RonGeezy.
And for those who may say, I don't remember that name, you was how far did you get on Last Comic Standing?
Last Comic Standing, I made the last six. There were two black people. I was the other dude. Wow. I was the other one. And the finalist on Who's Got Jokes first season. Wow. Me and
you couldn't win that?
It was George Wilborn.
You the worst.
No, say it again. He won that.
I went against George Wilborn.
Yeah, he won that. He didn't have the crackhead background. You got to have him.
Hilarious. All right.
Wow. Makita's in the house. Good friend of mine, y'all.
Oh,
how you doing? From Phoenix.
I like your braids.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
She got some beautiful lips.
You
got
to see the back of her neck. It's incredible.
Is her kitchen clean?
You look at the wrong
area. I paid $150 for this. My kitchen better be clean.
That's right.
Right.
New baby hair.
Thank you for coming out. And my boy, we play ball together every Tuesday and Thursday out in Calabasas. Kay in the house. We call him Detroit because he's from Detroit City. Kev, what's up, dog?
Hey, what's going on, Speedy?
You got to get right up on that microphone, fam.
Hey, what's going on, Speedy?
This nigga all hard as shit. You hard with a picture of you on your shirt.
But he was doing his nails a minute ago.
Speedy, what does he do? Is he a
You see my
player?
File?
He a rapper, man.
Oh, he's a rapper.
Yeah. He's 35 years old, and he just got in the game. So.
Exactly. Has he been to jail?
Nah, no. So he got a lot of catching up to do.
He must be soft.
He ain't no rapper. He got all his rap start off with.
Once upon a time.
Not long ago.
So we got a great show for you. 877-2106-106. We'll go around the table. You ain't dating nobody. We'll go to Ron G.
Hysterical.
When is the cuteness rub off for you? What does she do to make that run?
Actually, it runs out. That new car smell goes out the window when she says, Ron, we need to talk. That's always followed by where is this going. Once you say where is this going, it has jumped out the window. The new car smell is going.
Yeah, when they say, so what are we doing here?
What are we doing? Like, you showed up and I just want to talk.
I don't want to do nothing. Can we just hit and go?
Why are we having a conversation about this? You knew what you was doing.
That's not nice.
You grown.
Makita, when does it wear off for you with dudes?
When a dude starts farting in front of me.
Who are you dating?
I don't want to know what you eat.
Lactose intolerant
motherfucker. Are you cooking for him?
No.
No,
I don't cook.
Do you fart?
Chili with no beans.
That's why he farting. He hungry.
Do you fart?
Those are hunger farts. Identify.
I'll say this much. Okay. Women that want to talk to me while they're in the bathroom.
Oh, my God.
With the door open.
With the door open. Oh, my God.
That means she's comfortable. Don't judge her.
Yeah.
No, that's nasty.
Too much
comfortable in her skin. Front to back, you do that by yourself. All right.
Front to back.
If you don't get that, you don't get that, Speedy.
I don't wipe
that.
Women's ass. So wow. Why are you wiping that, all those kids? No. Anyway, Tate. Kim, when does it wear off for you, man? I know you're from Detroit. It's different in Detroit. Women so might cold, tell you when to get the fuck out.
It wear off for me, man. The first time she ordered mayonnaise around me in any situation.
What?
Miracle
mayonnaise. What's wrong with mayonnaise?
Look, a woman is not allowed. That is just the most whortish.
Hortish.
Thing.
Nigga, what's a hort?
That was a new word.
You gotta stay right on that mic.
It's a new word. I'm telling you, first time a woman ordered mayonnaise around me, it's a turn off to me. It's immediately going.
Really?
So you can't ever go to Subway with my ass.
What about wait?
I need extra mayo. Yeah. You turn around and it's gone.
No.
Wow. Are you serious, dude?
Man, that's how it's always been.
So it's pretty much if her nails grow or her hair fall out.
No. But I just know that when I start looking at the situation from a different angle, you know, I off the rip.
Now, is this after?
What angle is the mayonnaise coming out of this? Disgusting you like that.
It's just what it is.
Now, is this after you hit or before you hit?
This nigga's lactose. That's
clearly before.
He lactose.
Before you hit.
It's still a turn off. Like, I can't take, it's like to just know she's like on mayonnaise like that. That's just something that is just.
Nigga, on mayonnaise like it's crack or something.
Bitch, is that Miracle Whip? Get out!
Hey,
you know what I'm feeling here? I'm feeling from Kevin is that this is going to be his hit song.
What's the song?
I don't like a girl that like mayonnaise. That's gonna.
That don't even rhyme.
Now mayonnaise and Miracle Whip is those two different things.
No. Yeah,
because I like Miracle Whip.
Okay, Miracle Whip is acceptable, but I still feel like
to go to
somewhere and be like, yeah, let me get extra mayo. Come on, a woman.
Kevin, that's
what about ranch?
Really
I like ranch.
I don't want to say that's retarded.
Ranch, get a pet.
This nigga petty.
Yeah.
Why not? But why not, right?
You going to get toasted bread, too? You got your bread toasted, man.
I got to look all the grease. You come off your motherfucking toasted salad all the way home, goddamn bitches.
I see why you love Detroit. It's the mayonnaise capital of the world.
I love you, Sinead.
Hold on, you guys. 877-2-106-106. Sinead, when is it over with dude?
When that nigga choke me.
That ain't what you said, nigga.
Well, that was funny, though.
Yeah, I ain't gonna make it back. But.
When is the cuteness over with?
Well, the cuteness is over when you feel comfortable enough to go to the toilet and shit, then have me bring you a Coke while you still on. Nigga, somebody did that.
What happened?
He was considerate enough to send a text message. He was like, you send me some tissue, send.
No, no, no. This is how we went. We was on vacation. We was in the hotel. And he said, Sinead, can you bring me a Coke? So I'm like, oh, he must be in there shaving or something. And this nigga sitting on a toilet with all the sports section on the floor and was like, okay, cool. Can you close the door on your way out? I'm like, nigga, we ain't going to make it.
You know Michael Vick just got out. Bring me a Coke.
Yeah, that's I don't know if the Coke helped it come out easier, but he should have brought the Coke with them. You
so
know?
He's drinking the Coke and shitting and reading.
Yeah. what if he invited you on vacation while he was on the toilet? You turn that down? Like, nigga, you stink. This ain't vacation? Okay, I
that's
go.
Petty.
He go, your Coke. Petty. He go, yeah, your Coke with Coke.
That's petty. He had me bring you a Coke on a toilet. You naked. He was stark ass, butt ass naked. I don't want to see that.
Hey, listen.
Oh, that, yeah. But that's when you know you got to go to the bathroom. When you take off all your clothes.
Yeah. No socks or nothing.
You leave that. But you usually leave on one sock. You ever get, but you ever get to the bathroom and forget to bring something to read? So you just read anything? I'm going to read this Clorox. I'm going to see what's in this.
No, but he opened the door and got the paper out from the, you know, hilarious. They bring the paper and brought the shit in there and forgot the Coke. And so I'm like, nigga.
He got on a gold chain and a Timberland. One Timberland.
It's hot in here. 877-2-106-106. TDP, when is it over, man? When does the
when her homegirl come in from out of town.
Huh?
When her homegirl come in from out of town. I like her homegirl. I don't like her no more.
Okay.
It's over.
All right, we're going to move on. Louis Dix.
I'm so petty.
It's better than mayonnaise.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, for real.
Lou, when is it over, man? When dudes sleep with your wife?
Wow.
Yeah, that's pretty much the honeymoon's over.
Well, she turned down vanilla wafers.
Mayonnaise sandwich.
Okay, here's the thing, you all. Simple goodness. Radio Land. I brought some vanilla wafer cookies, which I really love. All right?
That box looks like civil rights movement.
And I also bring candy
keep
for
throwing
the crew.
Ron G. They go hit. One of them go hit.
I bring candy for the crew, and I just pass it out. So they always tease me about that. But I think it's over, Speedy, when she decides to get another dude. Yeah, it's over.
Wow. Yeah, that's a good one.
Pretty much.
I want to bring the room to a halt there, Lewis.
hey, listen, I'm a happy
awkward.
Dude, though.
And also in the house, your favorite girl and my girl.
Cause, yeah, it's over with her. Because
the body's off the chain. Diamond Double D is in the house. Ooh. Diamond, get on.
What's really good?
All right, when is it over? When is the cuteness over when you're dating?
Well, let's just see. I just got out of a relationship 2 days ago. That wasn't all. Don't R yet. Clap for her ass.
I'm the one that gave you the boot.
The nigga.
That's right. The last time you came, the dude came up here. I don't like niggas. I don't like dudes that have to follow. I don't like dudes that have to follow their girl because they don't trust them.
Right. Well, let's just say, okay, I got choked. And
that's
the
when
cops
it's over.
Were
just said that.
Yeah, what did you do?
I didn't.
You put some mayonnaise on nigga bread.
You know what I did? I instantly overdid it.
What you do, Kev? Why you took out?
Spit it back up.
And this is in front of everybody at the restaurant. I was watching the Orlando game at the time, and they
that
went
was
into
yesterday.
This was last week.
Mm-hmm. Just roll with it.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Okay.
That was yesterday.
Yeah, it was yesterday.
One of them is.
Yeah, it went into overtime, and I called him. I said, yo, babe, give me a second. The game went into overtime. He's like, fuck overtime. Come up now. I said, gotta watch overtime. And next thing I know, he was at the restaurant choking me out. Nigga, he came to the restaurant and choked you?
But
the game was over by then. You should have had your ass outside
by
then.
Diamond, did he choke you? How did he went past your upper things?
He actually got me from the
back.
Those
are called titties.
I know. I just didn't want
to
say that.
Wow. Upper things. That nigga is crazy.
No, you okay, though?
Why is Sinead wanting to write down his number?
I told you to see. You messing with the little guy.
I met him.
Stay focused with me, Lou. Stay so focused. All right, so we're talking about when is the cuteness over. On the phone, out of Texas, we got Douglas on the phone. Douglas.
Hey, what's happening? I want to say hey to everybody. And
what's up, dog?
Hey, Douglas.
When the relationship ain't cute no more? We dropped. Okay, you gotta get it to
Douglas.
Phone,
good
Douglas.
Looking out for the call.
Out of North Carolina, is it Bryson? Did I say it right?
Yeah, me.
Bryson, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here, man.
Yeah, you don't want to go to jail with that name. That's gonna get you.
Hey,
trouble.
Bryce, how you doing?
Want some Nilla wafers?
When is the cuteness over, Bryce?
Ain't it all, man, but I was honestly going to say, after you first hit it, man, like, depending on the terms you met the girl on in the first place, for the first time, and the first thing you know is her butt, you know what I'm saying, or how fine she is, whatever, you know what I'm saying, you put in all that work to get it, once you get it, it's like, dang.
For dudes, it's pretty much like that. Once we hit it, it's pretty much a wrap after that,
well,
ladies.
Let's be honest now. Sometimes, you know, we get it and we don't want it back either.
Have you ever felt that way about a dude? Thank you for the phone call. Like, as soon as he got up, you like, nigga.
Sometimes it don't even go down. It's just like, if that's the package you working with, this isn't going to work. Right?
Who's he fucking with,
Donna? Just got to step back. Like, and this is after mushroom. I waited. You know, this is after I took a good 30-day probation. Like, oh, right. Let me be that good girl. And then I was like, no. He got baby dick. Like the toddler dick.
Toddler dick. Wow. You know?
Louis, you raised your hand when she said toddler dick.
No, I wanted to ask her a question.
I'm looking for Pampers. Okay. Right.
When you look back, did you overlook some signs that would have said, okay, I shouldn't.
Like a size 7 shoe?
No, I mean as far as his abuse and different
SpongeBob
things.
No, no, Lou. No, no, Lou. Oh, okay, you was on the phone. I'm sorry.
I'm talking about my daughter in particular.
Yeah, but you fucked up the rhythm now. So anyway,
why is always me?
So that could definitely be the honeymoon could be over. 877-210-6-106. Call in. Let us know at what point.
Speedy, we got some good Twitter responses. Give it to me. Sag says it's over when you
Twitter
lose...
girl.
Oh, Twitter. Sag says it's over when you lose your job. It's hard to love a broke man.
Wow.
We are in a recession. All of that.
Yeah,
all
mayonnaise is high when you ain't got no job. God damn, $4.
Where the little packets at? Give me some packets.
Dude said the same thing.
877-210.
Dude says, I realize the relationship is over after I bust a nut and kick her ass out.
That's unnecessary. That's not good.
I agree.
I'll be real with you. Now,
he ain't busting the real nut.
Hold you, 27, young brother. You know, nigga, soon as you hit 9 out of 10, your sexiness is starting to wear off.
It's nap time.
No, it depends.
Take a nap. I don't even want to talk. I can't even say it out.
Hey, baby, this your house. Can you leave, though?
Pass me a Coke.
What kind of non-quality women are you dealing with?
That I want to stay there and hug and spoon?
Well, you're big girls. You can't just run up. You got to climb.
Wow.
It's like a journey. It's like climbing Mount Everest. Get off your babes.
Get off your babes.
Your babes.
Your babes.
Saturday Night Fever lingo.
Jab turkey.
Right. Some of these Nilla wafers.
You know what else does it for me? If you snore.
Most dudes do snore. Like, what kind of snore? Like, you about to die snore?
Yeah. Like,
like if I don't wake you up, motherfucker?
Running cardiac arrest. Right. Like the nigga was losing breath every night, you know?
What if he snored because he tired from work?
That's why he choked you, because you had too much air.
Yeah. He was trying to steal some of it.
You got to put the fan on him.
He had the fan on every night.
877-210-6-106 is the number. Call in. On the phone, out of Detroit. Kel, you may know
Motors.
We got Brian on the phone. Brian.
What's up, Speedy?
What's happening, man? When is the cuteness gone when you date, man?
I say, I got three of them. One, when a chick try to shish you like you a fucking preschooler.
Oh, ooh, don't shish me. Ooh, shit.
And number two, after, when you done gave her the dick supreme and they done had the muscle orgasm, you done sweat that hair out, cuteness is definitely gone.
Yeah, it's like what Eddie said. Once I hear you go, ooh, it's hey.
He said dick supreme. And if they ever try to hold that pussy over your head, use that as leverage, oh, it's a motherfucking rap. The cuteness is gone. If you're the only one with good pussy walking around here, then you better check yourself.
Thank you for the phone call, man.
Brian, you sound like a very sensitive, caring guy.
He is. He told the real.
Man, that's not real.
Lou, have you ever met a girl come?
What?
It's a real simple question.
What's this cum word you speak of?
What fourth you speak there, sir? Let me into your world.
My last name has been Dix my entire life.
That don't mean shit.
So I've had to hold up.
Lou, has a girl ever gave you the PIN number to her account?
Oh,
then you ain't hit it right.
Come on, Speedy. I've had cars given to me. Come on.
Ooh. Those are Hot Wheels, motherfucker.
Can you park this, please?
Some little girl gave you
Can you
a
park
Hot
this,
wheel.
Please?
Now, you got to charge the battery before you go to sleep.
877-210-6-106 is the number. On the phone, young lady out of St. Louis, we got Tiffany on the phone. Tiffany
is out of Louisville, Kentucky, not St. Louis. Get it
That's
right.
That's what they got on here. They got,
hey, Louisville.
They got it right. What's up?
What's up?
Bluegrass. Bluegrass.
Now, you represent for the ladies right now. When is it over?
It's over when the bitch-assness overpowers the relationship. when a nigga's bitch assness come out so strong like no mayonnaise on the sandwich.
Oh,
damn. Did you call it bitch assness?
Right. I didn't make that list.
In the Westerns right now. Bitch assness.
Damn, baby. Bitch assness.
When it overpowers the relationship,
I like that.
When you act more like a bitch than your dick is giving me, when you more of a bitch than a good power laying the damn nigga, then it's time to get up too.
She
got on Timberlands. I like her.
She's like, who you calling on the phone? My mama. Again? Bitch ass nigga, yeah. We
wow. Love her.
Louisville, listen to me, baby. This is Kevin Tate.
Mr. Mayo.
Hey, listen, I'm the guy about the man. That was about when the cuteness wear off, baby. I wouldn't put you away over no mayonnaise, though.
No, until you nut. Then you got to go with the extra mayonnaise.
That's just the cuteness, baby.
You
that's
can't
in
get
the
a $6 burger that's and extra mayonnaise.
Baby, take it to your head, not your heart, baby. Take it to your head,
I
not
like
your
Tiffany.
Heart.
Hey, Tiff, are you still there, baby?
A real nigga say, baby, look at that mayonnaise dripping from your motherfucking lips.
Let it drip right on your nipple. Let me suck it on off.
Fuck no.
She's a freak.
We're because the mayonnaise just turned your ass on. Real motherfucking nigga. Take it.
They should have reminded you a nut right on your chest.
Why
is
she saying
that? You don't want to aim at, nigga. Let the mayonnaise show you where to aim.
Hilarious. I love her. We're going to introduce you to Louis Dix.
No.
Louis, you need her.
Hey, I have to go home to Tiffany saying, what you do today, Louis? I just shot four people. All right, go on. Now you can have some.
No, she didn't say that. She just said you can't be a
she
bitch.
Just, she's a rider.
No, she is.
What is her name?
Scary.
Tiffany.
Tiffany about to get kissed in the mouth.
Ooh.
Tiffany, come get me.
I like Tiffany. Yeah, Tiffany can
thank
fight.
You for the phone call, baby girl. 877-2106-106 is the number. Tiffany, oh my goodness.
I felt excited.
You know why? Because I always wanted a girl to have your back, to ride or die.
Right.
I hate them little pretty bitches and you bill collect the call, she give you the phone. Bitch, what the fuck?
Like, that nigga's supposed, not home,
yeah,
nigga.
Supposed,
you
oh,
know
somebody,
I ain't got it.
Yeah.
Explain why
I told
to
you
die.
He moved, motherfucker.
That mean they got your back.
He's bipolar.
When the fight break out, she not looking at you going, what did you do? Bitch, they was trying to get at you. I'm going to fight. So I want the girl that's going, who fucking with you?
Go Let's get the car. It. I got this, nigga.
Yeah,
go
I
ahead. Go get the car. I got it.
She loosened up. She tightened up her Timberlands. That's what I'm talking about.
You want
right.
the one that ain't going to turn
like,
you
hold
in.
Hold my hair. I'm about to get,
there you
I
go.
You.
There you go.
Hold my hair. I'm about to get these
hey,
niggas.
Hold on. Hey, Sag.
Hold my hair.
Sag, who's on Twitter, she says she love you, Speedy. She says she love you. So oh, I want her to go on ahead and send us over a picture at Speedy's Comedy at Yahoo. We need to see what you look like while we're sitting right here.
Nice.
You know our saying here.
At Yahoo.com.
You know our saying here. Do you need the fan on you when you sleep?
Right. You need to answer that first. Yes or no. You ain't got to repeat the question. Just yes or no off the bat and then go and send a picture.
Yeah.
Also, Miss Coco said it's over when his first impression is introducing you to his kids on the first date, then trying to get some that same day.
Wow.
Hmm.
What's that wrong? Take me out the loop.
They done came to the shop. They
I'm like, will that be for sure for you if a dude said these are my kids is on the first time you meet him?
It depends on if I'm meeting him at Six Flags or if I'm meeting
Hilarious.
Him at Mastro's. There's a difference.
Mastro's?
What's that?
It's a steakhouse in Beverly Hills.
Yeah,
if I'm meeting
a steakhouse there last night.
Beverly Hills. Ain't that a bitch.
I'm saying if I'm meeting you
That's
at
a parking
restaurant.
Lot of
yeah, I drove by it a couple of times.
It ain't shit.
You singed it.
What about you, McKee? Same thing?
What?
If a dude walk up and say, these are my kids, before y'all even go out?
Yeah, I'm not really down with the kid thing. I'm still young, so.
How old are you?
I'm 24.
Okay.
See her lips,
I want to meet the kids because I want to know if I can deal with their little badasses. But you want to meet them on the first night?
The first
she
date?
You know, might not even be able to deal with his badass.
She want to know, can your son choke me? I want to see
his face. Put a little hand around my neck.
Yeah, you better not walk in nobody's house and they got an infant. They're going to jump
ever
right
let
on
nobody
you.
Put their hands on you like that. Was the dick good?
Nigga.
Wait a minute. Whoa.
Wait.
Hey, wait,
put up, women,
wait a minute.
No, because when women put up with stupid shit like that, because nigga landed
okay,
there.
Nigga.
But some females like to get choked out while they get it, though.
But she was that wasn't a while she was getting it type of situation. That was an inappropriate time to choke a nigga.
It was in advance. It was prepaid choke. It was, that was
she didn't answer the question yet.
Speedy,
yeah, answer the question.
No, she ain't got to answer
first,
that.
Speedy.
That's already.
No,
that's
Speedy, ask the question first.
No, that's the correct
no,
way
ask
to answer.
The question.
That's the correct way to answer it, Louis.
No,
you
no, I said the same thing.
Good Lord. 877-2106-106 is the number. We're talking about when in dating, not in marriage, but mm-hmm. when in dating is the cuteness over. When and the young lady, which I kind of, it's kind of dope when she says, he going to introduce me to all the kids and now you want to try to hit?
Right.
Yes, you usually got to sprinkle kids on. Bring if you got a lot
one
of kids.
One by one.
I don't bring them all over.
No, if you got a lot of cereal bowls in your kitchen, yeah. You already know it's a lot of
this
kids.
This is what I do. I bring one at a time.
Right.
I bring the cutest one first.
Right.
And I work my way up to the other one.
You said that as your
no, you and the baby hair. Come on, get out of the car.
No, the one with no hair staying. Yes. We ain't ready for you yet. You stay in the car. 877-2-106-106 is the number. On the phone, out of Pittsburgh, we got Jerome Stillers. Jerome, what's that?
What up, Rome?
No. You know.
You the truck nigga was?
Hello.
Can you hear me now?
PCS.
Good. Can you hear me now? Good.
All right, thank you for the phone call.
Oh, we got another comment.
Y'all make, you know, niggas don't call from landlines no more.
Right. No. Just
who has a home phone?
People don't use that.
You know the funny shit I saw somebody using the payphone. I wanted to go, nigga, you ain't got a cellular?
You can't borrow a cellular from your friend?
And he was with his girl.
Damn.
Wow.
That's a bad situation.
That's love right
they ain't gonna make
it. They had a motherfucking buggy with the baby in it.
That's broke love.
No.
Hey, was you watching them with popcorn?
I was at the light, nigga.
Light turned green and you were just sitting there staring.
I went to get my phone. I was like, nigga, here, make that call.
Right.
No, that phone could have been dead.
That's love. Now, see, that's what I mean, ride or die.
That's what I mean, Louis.
Like, she was with the shelter.
Yeah, there you go.
If you need 50 cents for the payphone, that's a ride or die.
She gave you a quarter.
She gave you a quarter.
Yeah, that's ride or die right there.
Hold on. We got a Twitter comment. It says, you know it's over when my first date with your girl is on your mattress. True story.
Well, you know what? That's not appealing.
No, I didn't get that.
Tell that little born ATL.
Tell that little Twitter sucker that's not impressive.
Hey, Speedy, I got one.
Get your own mattress.
Go ahead, Ron G in the house.
Get her on your own mattress.
When a woman invites you on a date and assume you're going to pay. And y'all still knew.
Yeah, I do have a problem with that. I do have a problem.
You should. If she's any kind of woman.
What you should do, the way it should go, is when the bill comes, Lou, what do? You automatically grab it?
Bill's already paid for.
You got it.
I look up. See, Bill's paid for.
Oh, he went there.
I'm
going to
show you what I did today.
But at McDonald's, you can just give me
$10. No, let me tell you what I did today.
Lou don't look like he likes
McDonald's. This girl called me, and she said she was round 3. She said, I'm going to have lunch right outside this restaurant. You come by. I said, oh, cool. So I went by. I only had like 20 minutes. Stopped by. She was eating. I sat down. I said, excuse me. I have to go to the bathroom. Went to the bathroom, paid her bill, tipped the waitress, and came back, talked a little bit, then rolled.
Oh, you are the bomb.
That's great. That's
nigga, you got a gang of cool points for that shit.
I would have bit her burger, jumped in the car, and kept it pushing.
Gang. Ain't hit it, ain't tried to hit it, nothing.
Yeah, that's gang. That's gang.
Yeah,
I ain't
but
gonna lie.
The waiter went and said he ain't pay for shit. That's
the girl was blown away. The waitress was blown away.
LD pay.
Did she call you back? Did she call you?
Of course you call back. Yeah, you don't call
no,
back.
Don't
so what is the problem, Lou, when they kick it with you by yourself? That's
no,
the problem.
It's not a thing about kicking it. That was, she's a nice girl. I like her. It takes time. That
you want the kids?
No.
She's handsome.
No,
I take
she's
fine.
A lady, dude.
No,
do fine. Look like a lady.
You all can tease all you want.
She looked like her daddy.
No,
I ain't never met her.
I'm actually on your side.
I date some good.
She got a hairy throat.
Nice shit. I like that. You know, yeah.
Daddy right, face, so mama body.
We'll just slide with that. So
thank you, D.
On the phone.
No, I mean, I've been paying bills for the past month. You know, so
you
and
have.
And you got your phone?
No.
You've been paying. Hold on.
That
hold on. Stop. Hold on.
Stop the presses.
Nigga, did I hear you say you was paying this nigga's bills?
I know.
Not the nigga that I met in the club. This got to be a different dude. It can't be the same dude.
He was on Section 8. It was put up.
Ty Bridges.
What was he
bringing? He was Section 8. It was $18 for rent.
What kind of game was he
bringing? You know, I'm going to ask Diamond, is it okay? Because I want to make sure. I don't want, me and Diamond is cool. I don't want no issues when we get off the mic.
It's okay. Don't worry about it.
You don't want no tangerine shit?
No, that didn't work for her. Yeah. Anyways, okay, so we in the club, right?
Just don't say his name.
I don't even know his name.
Ty Bridges. You don't want to say no nigga name that actually comes behind you and choke you.
No, but that ain't even the worst, okay? We
Chris
in the
Brown.
Club. Diamond a little tipsy. I'm like, I tell her girl, I said, go, you know, go get the car. Me and Diamond going to walk out. This nigga walks up and was like, bitch, you a motherfucking, what did he I didn't even want to go there. Some of the shit was just too much. And then he was like, now we in the club. The lights is on. We leaving the club. I'm like, dude, please. I didn't know this was our dude. I'm like, dude, please. You ain't no fucking lady. In the club, everybody. I'm like, I got Diamond. I'm holding her. I'm like, nigga, this bitch big. I got my sweat and shit. Not
like
that.
Are you trying to say Diamond is bigger
than
you?
No, she thick. She bigger than me. But she thick. she too big for me to be carrying when I'm tipsy, too. That shit was not sexy on the way out. And I'm like, Diamond, for real, girl. She called me. She was like, yeah, my dude mad. I'm like, that was your nigga? Yeah, girl, he got my core. He brought your core after cussing
you from L.A. You from L.A. That's a total L.A. thing. You got my core.
Oh,
Yeah. Wow. Nigga had the board.
Again, Speedy.
The nigga had the board.
I'm a ride or, you know.
You ride
I'm,
or die?
I'm ride or die, you know.
You just die right now.
Yeah, pretty much.
How did you guys
straight
meet?
Dying.
Where did you meet?
Choke you to sleep.
Where did you meet?
When the lights on.
At a boxing match.
Y'all see the lights while I get choked? Just dim the lights just a little bit. Everybody
you usually meet somebody like that at a
hold my drink. He about to choke me. Hold my drink.
Where'd you meet him?
Rehab.
Where'd you meet him?
Did you?
This is that rehab.
This nigga gonna knock my ponytail under the bar.
No, that's where you usually meet somebody like that. It usually goes that way.
At a jail conference.
At jail. She was visiting her other dude.
Okay, let's see what happened. How did it happen? How'd you
meet him? Was he at your parole hearing or something?
Just gonna knock my ponytail under the register. Wait a second.
Is that why everybody hates Chris got canceled?
Of Georgia, we got Kevin on the phone. Kev, you there?
Yeah, what's up? What's going on, Speedy?
What's up, man? When is the sexiness over, man?
Oh man, the cuteness ever, all cuteness. Of that over with when literally you fuck the shit out of a girl.
That's there right. That's right. Yeah. Now, how do you know though? What are your clues?
Dude was on the bed.
Ooh.
Oh, hey. He said literally.
What?
He said literally.
Little Cocoa Puffs.
Yeah.
He said literally, right?
No raisin
last time.
Tricks are for kids.
Got raisin
dude
on
the
bed.
Wait a second. Got Prop 8 written on that show.
Eat cornmeal. Right,
go ahead, dog.
Nigga said literally.
Literally.
Is that a Skittle still in the shell? Wait a second.
Go ahead, dog.
Swallowing it whole?
Nugget on the bed, you know. And we both looking at each other like, where that come from, you know?
Wow.
He said a golden nugget.
Wow, that's nasty.
The only thing she could do was get up, get a piece of tissue, and throw it in the trash.
Wow. She's mixed with Cocker Spaniel. 877-2106.
I dated the girl for 90 days, and she finally gave it up and did that to me. Man, I put it.
Are you serious?
Shit it on the bed?
Hey, this nigga's a walking colonic.
Wow. Wait, did you hit it in her ass? Is that why she shit it on the bed?
No. I wasn't hitting it in the ass. I mean, I
shit
it?
I don't like where this conversation is going.
I think she fooled you to think you was hitting it to the back. She had to go to the bathroom. That's what it was.
She was going, stop, I got to go.
She was holding it for 9 months.
Right.
I'm going to make you go. Thank you for the phone call,
nasty
man.
Nasty story.
877-2106-106.
Chocolate snow cone on the bed.
I thought he was joking when he said fuck the shit out. He was serious.
Literally.
Fuck, I told you, literally. Y'all judging me.
Yeah. But look, think about it. Where does the conversation go after that when you wake up and go, hey, is that yours?
Hey, now.
What is that snail? Who is that in my mattress?
I don't mean to offend you, Speedy, but I'm going to ask this question.
Yes.
Right.
You're going to. But before you ask that question, we got a break. We're going to come right back in Speedy's Comedy Corner. 877-2106-106.
Talking about Hershey Kisses.
All along
we want to know, when does the cuteness wear off? 877-2106. It's Speedy's Comedy Corner, and I'll
when
be
you say I'm Speedy
up in this.
Biatch.
When we back, it's Speedy's Comedy Corner, and I'll be
Speedy
up in this.
Biatch.
Y'all better stay focused on what the hell's going on here.
Biatch.
Wow. That last story wasn't no joke. He really fucked the shit out
that
of her.
Is.
We're talking about when does the cuteness wear off?
Man.
In the house, my girl, the dress is on fire.
My
hair
goodness.
Is whipped. Jamie's in the house. Jay, tell him what you do, baby girl.
Yes. Jamie in the house. Hello. I'm an entertainer, modeling, acting, a lyricist, and I own my own company called Sleepless. You
okay.
can check us out.
That's
at
just too many jobs.
I like the hair.
Never too many
She's
jobs.
Jamaican.
Yeah, you got it.
The hair is, hold on.
Which
the hair.
Job
did you have that hair the last time you came?
No. Speedy. I might have had it, but it wasn't on my head. You did.
Oh, that's the Whitney Houston collection.
I'm telling you, she does look like Whitney.
Same Which body. Whitney?
Is this
before
pre-crack?
Crack? Right, or after the crack?
This is a national anthem.
I mean, but it's still Whitney. I mean, it's like
bodyguard number two.
Good to have you back. So the question that we're throwing out is in dating. When does the cuteness wear off?
Ooh, does the cuteness ever wear off?
When you're dating a guy, is it after he hit or before? Well, you ain't.
It's after he just start acting a fool. The lying, the hot messiness of a dude, that's when he becomes unattractive.
Bitch assness.
Yeah.
That's a new word.
That's not
Tiffany.
Where have you been? That's not a new word. That's Puffy's
bitch assness?
That's Puffy's word. That's,
he got t-shirts that and everything. Website.
Puffy has already claimed that.
She hasn't gone after Puffy's money yet.
Take that, Louis. Also back another week because the everybody on Facebook loved your shit, man. Roy's in the house.
Yes, yeah. Funny. Yeah.
Prank calls. I listened to the whole DVD.
Don't
that shit is fucking
hilarious.
Hilarious.
Do you always wear blue shirts?
It's the same.
He's a supervisor at Toys R Us, my boy.
Take the badge off and walk right in.
Roy, I just wonder.
Clean up on L7.
Don't start no crippin' drama.
Now, Roy, for you, man, when does the cuteness wear off on young? Is it after you hit or before?
It's before. I got weird turnoffs, though. I mean,
it can't be weirder than Kev. Kev's the only like,
nah, it ain't
put mayonnaise on the sandwich. Man.
So, yeah, but too much mayonnaise is a wrap.
Yeah,
but what you get a Miracle Whip pass.
I don't like people who want to come over. I don't like people who don't know when to leave my house. Like, and it ain't even about dating. It's just about, all right, we watched a movie. The movie is ended. It's clear you ain't going
to Maybe
fuck.
She's trying to get
Can
you
Can he
some.
Finish the subject?
No.
That's what y'all don't
just mean. Leave. Because if I fall asleep on you, then I'm an asshole.
Yeah. Otherwise, what I see, that's, you need to be choked. Where, Donnie, where you away from? Yeah. You need to be over here choking the shit out of Sinead. So when the movie's over and you find out that they ain't going to fuck.
Yeah, I mean, even if they don't want to fuck, just leave. If you're, just go home.
You know what I hate? And it's a dude here that know what the hell I'm talking about.
Shit to do.
Yeah, fellas, you ever have a girl call you, say she want to come kick it, then afterwards she tell you she's on her period?
Yeah.
I pretty much want to touch
somebody. So come kick it, don't mean kick it, then.
Right. No, because if you come by my house.
No, you then you expect in the booty.
Yeah, yeah. You
don't call me when you're making ketchup.
Oh, wow.
Don't call me.
877-2-106. What are you going to say, Roy?
Speedy, you ever had somebody tell you that they on their period and then they pause and they waiting for you to go?
What day are
you?
Okay.
Yeah. Don't get me wrong. What I need to know what day are you?
Just, if it's five or if it's three.
Are you spotting? No, are you spotting?
Spotting.
Johnny Mac, if you spotting, it's okay.
No. It's good.
No.
Yeah, it's good.
No.
That's
no.
Good.
If you at the end of it.
No.
That's good.
No. No. No.
That's what the bad towels are for.
Right.
That's what the bad towels are for.
Her cycle, it's the cycle. You don't do it while she's nasty.
You don't have
wait, you were married and never did it while she was on her cycle?
No ketchup. On
no,
the hot dog.
No.
Oh,
no mayonnaise either.
No mayonnaise either. No mayonnaise.
Damn, Lou. Condiments is out the door in this house. You mean, are you serious?
Now, when you're married, it should be different. You should be able to get it at...
All the time.
Yeah.
Except day one and two. You just don't want to do
actually,
that.
Actually, I was kind of lucky. I didn't have a bleeder after a certain one.
What does that mean?
She a robot?
No.
That blow-up dog don't bleed at all.
Yeah, the plastic hurt, but after the third child.
As long as you lube up the blow-up, it's okay.
Bloodless.
On the phone, out of Kentucky, we got
Bluegrass.
Big L is on
bad
there.
Bad situation. Yeah.
Big L.
What's up, Shotter?
Big L, you there?
Don't come in.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
How you doing, Big L?
What's cracking?
I'm trying to find out.
Yeah, we're waiting for your sentence.
What are you doing, man? When is the cuteness over in the relationship?
A couple situations, man. This is all for the females, for real. I see a couple females kicking for a while, and then when it's time to do, you smell like metal pipes. I don't like that.
Hilarious. Okay.
You smell like what?
Metal pipes.
Wow. I don't like that.
What is that?
What's that
smell like? When your pussy stinks.
So you didn't want to give it.
That means she has an infection, motherfucker.
So basically, her pussy smells like exhaust.
Wow.
Metal
exhaust.
Nigga okay. Fucking in the junkyard.
Flowmasters.
Maybe it's
pussy
so
smell like Flowmasters.
going out with mechanics.
Wheelchair oil.
Bitch, is that nitro? Did you get the nitro?
Valvoline.
8772. Thank you for the phone call.
Valvoline.
We got a young lady on the phone out of Texas. Sure. We got. Tanya?
Tina.
Hey, Tina.
Shut up,
Johnny
Man.
You learned you how to read.
Oh, that's the wrong one. I'm looking at the wrong person. Oh, Tina, no. Are you there?
I'm here.
How you doing, baby? So for
I'm
God,
good.
When you dating a guy, when is the cuteness over?
When I finally let you spend the night over to my house and we get down, you don't even go down on me, but the next morning you roll over and your breath smells like hot rubber. The cuteness is over, boo-boo. Go home.
Well, the problem is you. You didn't give us no brochure and a code of conduct before we came over. Motherfucker, where's your welcome?
I think information kit.
So definitely for you, he got to go down on you right then and there.
I mean, first of all, when you come over, make sure you don't have a tickler. Make sure you actually have...
Hilarious. She said another.
Well, she might not be go down cute.
First of all,
yeah,
Tina,
your pussy about to like pastrami meat.
No, boo. Well, I make sure all of that is clean, pretty.
How do you look?
Neat.
Send us a picture. How do you look?
But boo. Tina.
Yeah,
you
what's up?
You really should not be inviting so many guys over to your place to find out how you smell or smell
hey,
them.
Hey, Louis, leave her
get
alone.
Get in a committed relationship.
Well, actually, Louis. Because the last time I called in, you had an issue with what I said as well.
Uh-oh.
Actually, Louis, I was dating the guy for 6 months. I did not let him come over to my house, nor did I let him know where I lived until we actually seen that it might have gone past 6 months. But I didn't know that he had hot ass breath.
It's the morning time now. You should have corrected.
Red rooster breath.
Why didn't you help the relationship go further?
Don't talk to me in the morning, and steam is coming from your mouth. So basically, your mouth is not open.
But did he have a toothbrush at your home?
No, he didn't, Lewis.
He was prepared to spend the night, so that would let you know.
I'm gonna put some peppermints by your bed and stop complaining.
He stayed the night. Some mouthwash. Then the next morning, what would it have smelled like?
Did you sleep with the fan on?
Give me a call later, Tina, so we can talk. That's
always, we always need to know that on the show. Do you sleep with the fan on?
Ryan, I feel you, though. I mean, I give a welcome kit.
Thank you for calling, baby.
Do you? Call me later on, Tina.
Brush your tongue.
Before I get here, thank you for joining me at the Diamond Palace.
No, you know what I do? I do bring my mints.
Tongue scraper.
And I bring a little thing. Especially if I go down on you.
Oh, my God. Like, are you kidding me?
It just Luke, be you thighs around you your ears, don't it?
You can't get no PIN number if you ain't going down, Luke.
What's that phrase kids use? Too much. What is it? TMI.
Too much information.
TMI.
Go ahead, Roy.
And how do you know where to go down on your big girls? There's so many layers.
Seven layer cake.
Pick a sweaty crevice.
You gotta throw flour on there.
Do it ever be musty in them cracks?
Yeah,
sweetie. That's what I need.
Or do you just leave little bars of
smell like a Super Bowl between her legs?
And while she's walking up the steps, they just dissolve.
He take pieces of a deodorant before he go down there and caress that shit in the crevices.
Your girl standing there, can you tell if she's standing forward or backwards?
Hilarious.
Now, the other one was funny, Lou. When you said, do you throw water? 877-206-106 is the number. Lou, your daughter's calling you again.
Oh,
this is a damn shame.
Wow.
So, now, Jamie.
Yes.
Last time you was here, you were celibate.
Celibate?
Yeah, she was
celibate. Celibate.
She was celibate in the bed. So, did you find a man?
No, I don't have a man.
Okay. New vibrator.
So for you, for sure, when you're dating, when will he truly fuck up by doing what?
Asking you for it, you'd be mad.
Actually, if he asked too early, that is kind of like.
Now, what is early?
When is too early?
After 5:30.
The first. after 5:30.
Because that outfit you got on, I'm going to ask as soon as we get in the car.
I mean, you could ask. I'm going to just tell you now.
Marcus.
I don't have any panties on.
Strong J.
Marcus.
I think we can agree if he's asking you for it and just gave you the number, that's probably a problem.
I don't know.
Now, how would you know unless a nigga choke you out? Your bar is a little bit warped right now.
You're bringing all right, up my
on the phone. Secrets. On the phone out of Ohio, who the fuck is this? Desiree's on the phone. Desiree. Desire. I was about to say, hey, look here, Desi.
You're so stupid. Your vocabulary.
Desiree, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
How you doing, baby? So when is
the cuteness
over?
You?
I'm doing real good. Thank you for calling the show, too.
Basically, the cuteness wears off whenever you always talk about how good your sex is. And then when it comes down to it, you ain't worth nothing.
So you find out it ain't worth nothing. What do you tell him afterwards? Don't you lose the number? Take it out your phone?
Basically, whenever he gets ready to leave, I say, I'll call you tomorrow. And then
hilarious.
I don't ever call back.
She sounds cute.
Hey, you ever had a girl, Speedy?
Hold on, I'm talking to her.
Sorry.
Desiree?
Desiree, you ever do it on the bed?
Yeah.
Hell no.
Did you hear that one?
You don't leave Hershey kisses for your lover.
A Hershey mint.
Desiree's a pretty name. I like that name.
Thank you for the phone call, baby.
We got a tweeter.
Twitter.
It's Twitter, nigga. It's Twitter.
Like, who learned you how to spell?
Retard.
Twitter.
Right. Raise your body.
Anyways, SKMPA said,
S-K-I-M-P-A.
You know it's over when you see bitches finally take her hair off and makeup and look like Flavor Flav in the face. And you feel scammed.
Yeah.
I like the power.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Because the girl you like is in a chair.
Yeah, I pretty much, I don't mind women to have weaves, but I like to put my hand in your hair, so it's not.
You think you are James Dean or something?
Because I know me, I'm going to put my hand, and you know how y'all pull away and go, mm-mm.
Right.
Yeah, and when you hear a woman go, mm-mm.
That's, like, you can touch the first top of the crown of the head, but don't come back to the lower part.
Don't get the kitchen.
Can't touch my weave.
I don't mind. Wow.
Well, you know
what?
Yours, you can tell.
I mean,
you're weaving like you just got choked.
You're
I'm just
not
saying.
When you feel oh.
I'll tell you this. I was just hoping my hair didn't come off at the restaurant. I said, please, God, just
Diamond.
Don't.
He choked you in public?
Forget she couldn't breathe. She was worried about her
Lewis,
hair.
Lewis.
You did not call the police?
Lewis.
They called the police.
Did he get arrested?
Lewis.
He left before he could get arrested in her car.
I'm sorry.
Lewis, you got to stay focused on
the whole story.
Choking don't mean shit if you do it at home. That ain't
right,
really choking.
That's not
when you choke in public, you a pimp.
She wasn't worried about her oxygen.
That's just checking for necklace size.
She's worried about hair, yeah.
Yeah, if you choke at home, it's kind of like, you know, you just...
Checking for necklace size.
Just teaching you a little. but in public?
Yeah, that's
right, boy, the worst.
Damn, you stayed with him? How long did you stay with him?
How long was you with that nigga?
Long enough.
To get
6 months.
Yes, Lewis.
Well, Speedy, what I was wondering is, we all tolerate
You're
certain
not on the
things. We all tolerate certain things in the beginning of a relationship. And then when we're ready to get out of it, we turn it on the people. You know, certain things are funny when a guy's being funny. Then after you're done with him, you get mad at little jokes that he did. So I think we all play that same game. And look who walked in. This guy got a haircut.
Corey.
Somebody messed your front up, though, bro.
What happened?
Corey's wife let him out.
Corey,
your wife cut your hair.
Diamond, come sit right here, baby girl. Cool. Corey Holcomb is, yeah, I'm glad you came, nigga.
You got an excuse.
Oh, that's how your hair got 877-2106-106.
On the phone,
great excuse.
We got out of Ohio, we got Black Ice.
Black Ice.
When is the sexiness over, Black Ice?
Black Ice, that sounds like a pimp.
Come on, Black Ice. Is it here? All right, Corey, get the phone. Come on, man. What the fuck is he doing?
My bad, man.
Wow, you act like you can't do anything without him.
Oh.
Wow.
I'm just scared. He's just like, go, Corey, get the phone now. Come on, Corey.
Like a jilted lover.
Jealousy in that.
Yeah, really.
So,
like, what about
Corey,
us?
We're talking about when does the cuteness in the relationship wear off? Is it right after you hit, pretty much?
It depends on the girl, right?
But don't it depend on... Nobody's brought up... Okay, according to...
Please do, go ahead.
...some research that has been done...
How many stages is
there's
it?
There's 5 stages
oh, okay.
in a relationship.
Five?
Okay, let's
go through. Actually, 6.
Let's
okay.
go.
Okay. Well, the first one is the meeting, obviously, the initial stage.
Hot.
Initial contact. Right. How you doing? And then stage 2 is the dating stage, also known as the romantic stage or the honeymoon stage, where people actually get to, you're infatuated. You're still consumed by whatever it is that got you to that point.
Get to rubbing her coochie.
Not yet.
Oh, okay.
You still infatuated by the looks. That's 2 to 3 months. And then you get into the differences. Now you done hit it, and now you start to realize the shit that you really don't like about that person.
Oh.
And those
people, after you hit, yeah.
That sounds like a bitch thought. Like a woman's frame of mind. You know
like
what I mean?
Mean?
Hey, Corey, we had a caller for you. This girl named Tiffany, when I tell you she was your flavor, nigga,
she was
ride or die. She was ride or
and
die.
And she did it on the bed.
Oh, no.
Yeah, we had a dude said that he fucked the shit dude. Out of somebody.
That was
but, really fucking.
Oh,
no. But,
But no. So anyways, then you go to stage 4, which is when you decide, I want to be with this person, and you develop some kind of communication level, which keeps you guys involved and keeps the relationship going. And then stage 5 is the healthy commitment stage, where you say, this is the person I'm going to be with. Most people don't make it past stage 4.
Stage 6. Speedy's been to stage 6.
What is stage 6?
Stage 6 is the pregnancies.
Oh. Wow.
No, that happens on stage 1 for Speedy.
Stay with the bitch because she's pregnant?
Yeah. Out of Texas, Lewis, we have Lewis on the phone.
Hey, what up, Lou?
What's up with it, man?
Hey, what's happening,
Lou? Hey, Lewis.
Hey,
good man.
The worst thing is when them women, when they want the money stage.
Oh, okay.
You hit the meat. They be wanting the money. Everything be going just fine, and then they have little problems with
rent paid or some stupid
shit. That's what I'm saying. That's how a man would think, because you know how women do. Men know if they want to be with the bitch when they see her.
Right. Yeah. No, this is true.
Man, I had this old one girl. She called me crying on the phone. So I never did say ask her what's wrong, because she's going to tell you that anyway.
You're wrong.
Old school player.
Crying. So I never asked her, but she eventually going to bring it out, because it's always a money thing. Every situation, money.
Yeah, they call you and go, you know my car in the shop. Well, it's going to be in the shop.
Well, that mean the dude ain't got your back. If you say, Speedy, my car's in the shop, and you don't say, baby, what can I do to help get it fixed? Can I take it to my boy who can fix it?
But I just mentioned,
if you volunteer to fix random bitch's car, you a lame motherfucker.
But if you didn't hit it, does that count?
Thank you for the phone call, man.
Only bitch who car you supposed to fix is your motherfucking real girl. If it ain't your real girl, the rest of the bitches get a meal.
So it don't matter if you hit it or not. That sex has nothing to do with it.
with whether you guys fix the girl's car or not.
Gold digger.
That's why I am the way I am.
And that's a different subject. All right, so call in. Let us know, when does the cuteness wear off? We want to know. 877-2-106-106 is the number.
What if they start off ugly?
Those are your dates. Anyway.
Wow.
I guess.
On the phone, back on the phone, out of Ohio, we got Black Ice. Black Ice.
Hey, what's going on, y'all?
What's happening? Yeah, you got a better phone.
Ain't nothing happening, man. No, I lost my reception. You know, these old raggedy-ass Sprint phones, you know, man. We're climbing this
mountain. Fucked up.
But, you know, but, man, shit, man, I tell you, man, I had this crazy motherfucker, man. You know,
we was in
tell. Good, man. Oh, man, you know, man, I met on the internet and shit. You know, I hit it like 3 times, and, you know. And, you know, a lot of times we'd be in the chat room talking, and she gonna come talking some shit about, well, you said this to such and such. You know, her little... Got a little spies in the room and stuff. Mm. I'm like, you know, bitch, don't call me no more.
So she Black Ice, she went 007.
How old are you, Black Ice?
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm 42.
Well, you 42. Why are you not out talking to real people?
Damn.
Oh, shoot. You know, I just do it for entertainment there, you know, because, you know, a lot of times out here you get bored. You know, y'all do the entertainment at nighttime, but, you know, when I'm sitting around doing nothing in the daytime, you know, I'll be in the chat room while I'm waiting to load the stuff, you know, and, but, you know, shit, it's just entertainment to me. But, you know, like I say, matter of fact, one of them hit, you know, and I just like, you know, we can't.
All right, Black Ice, thank you for the phone call.
He said some real shit, though. Don't matter if you meet him in the chat room or if you meet him in person. 9 times out of 10, the bitch going to cross you later on anyway.
He going to meet a big old
We want Tiffany to call back. Tiffany, call back. We want to introduce you to Corey. You going to like Tiffany.
Tiffany, why the fuck
out? Because you're going to like her flavor, her flow.
Tiffany was hard. She had hard. She thought like you. She had the thought process.
She was you. On the phone out of Las Vegas. I'll be there July 3rd and 4th in Vegas. My man Big Steve is on the phone. Big Steve.
Hey, Steve.
Hey, y'all, yeah, man. Hey. Motherfuckers.
Wasn't us, man. It was the other dude. When does the cuteness wear off for you, man?
But anyway, it's pretty much over when you put the tip in and she starts screaming for no reason.
The tip.
Yeah. So you don't like people that's overreacting.
No, you must have a small tip.
I just don't like people to fake the shit.
Yeah, don't fake it.
Prime example. I went over to a girl's house. And she was pretty much.
You know, Melinda's.
Yeah, she was pretty much 30. How'd you know her name? She was 30. And so she was eating ham hocks, right?
Wow.
Ew. She fired right
trying
there.
She was trying to, you know, give me that, have some of that coke and yak early in 5 early in the freaking morning. And so she takes me to the bedroom, right? And right before I get ready to hit it, she falls asleep.
Wow.
Mm. It was that coke and that yak.
She could be old. She like 70-something. How old was she?
Do niggas still use coke?
She was 31. She's 31.
She overweight.
Slow metabolism.
Thank you for the phone call. 877-2-106-106 is the number. In the house out of Connecticut, Mike's on the phone. Mike.
Mike.
Huskies. Mike, you there? Sprint phone. We got any Twitters, not tweeters, on the phone.
No Twitters? No Twitters. Updated Twitter.
Those people.
Every girl ain't faking, though. Some girls, they have, they get stimulated. They pussy be stimulated in different places.
What?
Some girls, the shit that excite they pussy ain't where you thought it was.
But apparently Diamond likes to be choked out.
Diamond don't like to be choked out. I was just in a horrible situation. That's all.
Diamond, you stay with him, Diamond?
Huh?
Yeah.
You took him to your mama house.
How you gonna stay with somebody that chokes you?
He mama met your mama.
Just great, yeah. Mama.
That mean if I don't choke you, I'm a
if
great
If a man
date.
Choke you and you leave him, you weren't never down with him anyway. That's the truth.
That's real shit.
877-2-106-106
because I choked
her. You're listening to Speedy's Comedy Corner, Sirius 106 XM 149. We're talking about in dating, not in marriage. When is the honeymoon
now, Speedy,
over?
That's what he said. It sounds like, and correct me if I'm wrong, because I'm new to getting into this dating thing. Is it true that you once a guy, all they care about is sex? So it's like if you hit it,
sports, sex. Yeah. And
I think
sports.
A dude show you what he want from you. Like if a dude is really interested in you. Like, in a way, like, you know, he's trying to really be with you. He show you that, but then...
How does he show you? Give us some examples.
He'll go to the store with you.
It's a whole bunch of examples you can use, but you will see the genuine interest other than just trying to get some pussy. But when a nigga just wants some pussy from you. I hate when girls try to act like he was interested in me. He be like, damn, bitch, when, I was just trying to get some
but
pussy.
But how do you tell the difference you between like being I was really digging in you. And that game that you
when he be like, where you at, bitch? I'm finna come through. That mean he ain't really interested
well,
in
okay,
you
okay, so
like
if
that.
He doesn't try to have sex with you or he doesn't initially make any kind of passes, does that
we never
mean? He's Louis Dix.
Does that mean
a gentleman.
Does that mean that
a
he's
gentleman.
Interested?
Yes. I don't know. I mean, that's a weak ass nigga if he ain't trying to get no pussy from you right away and
goodness
he ain't really
gracious.
Trying to be with you.
I'm trying to get it right
how
now.
How do you tell the difference between
you
when
can't.
He's
you can't.
Lying
you
just to get it?
You
and
don't.
Then,
you don't know it until I come over. And
hit
you,
it.
And
see,
you
that's
say,
why you're not coming over.
And you say, nah, it ain't cool. And I go, I wasn't trying to get down nowhere. I just wanted to get some water.
Good point.
If a dude treats you respectfully, and then he stopped treating you respectfully after he got the pussy, that's weakness in the dude, because I treat you disrespectfully. You see, I ain't shit.
I mean,
I'm not going
right out the gate.
I ain't gonna be like, he came out the bag on me. No, bitch.
Exactly.
You know
I don't like representatives.
Pussy from me.
I'm saying.
I got a real girl, bitch.
And see, that's what I'd like to hear right from the part, right from John.
Why
a lot of women can't
because
handle it,
let's not play around. Like,
you
if that's your situation,
though.
Yeah. And
no.
you
y'all
you supposed to at least give the person a chance to
we
choose
do
want to be
I
in a situation
every
or not.
Dude has a
Jamie,
main girl.
I think the titty popped out.
I like
every
that.
Dude, I mean,
real.
It's the truth. Every dude has a main girl.
Nipple.
They gonna have somebody on the side, but they gonna have
that
main
spot.
Chick.
That main girl spot is earned. That means you did something to make
that
him
means,
be like, I fuck with you like that.
Right.
But any other girl, you got to get to that point. Any motherfucker that just declare you his woman and he don't know you, that's another sign of a weak man.
Here's something I believe.
Or he full of shit and he trying to get it.
Here's what I believe.
But a lot of times they don't be full of shit. They be like, what's up with the pussy, bitch? Oh, well, fuck
this
it.
Is how a guy.
Then y'all be like, oh,
they,
he ain't no
trying
good.
To the time. I need to hear a gentleman tell me what
this
it is.
This is how a male man base if a woman cares about him. It's how she treats him. Meaning that, it's how she treats him. Meaning if she reacts to him or responds to him. Meaning if he's having a hard day and then she beats him up more, that she's reacting to him, not responding. But she allows him to get through that day because she knows.
But that's
that,
how you guys.
What's
know.
The game again? What's the question again?
The question is, how does a woman know? How do we decipher between bullshit
you
and genuine
you could do that.
Article
if you
of
could
a man?
It's so hard. It's so hard to explain, but I do think a lot of y'all should go and have a talk with your mom because your mom ran your dad away when he was young, and he never got a chance.
Hysterical.
To show
my
you
parents
the game.
Were together for 27 years thus far, so I don't think I could ask my mom that. Well,
okay, but wait, what?
You
grew up with a two-parent household.
I did.
Do you have children?
No.
You see what I'm saying? It's like it's things that. No, I didn't mean that. I'm
no.
saying.
No, you're right.
That's good.
Hold
there
on.
Are signs
so you're trying to say
if she saw both sides of the fence.
So you're trying to say if it was just her mama, she'd have four kids by now?
I'm saying a lot of girls who grow up just off what they mama talk about be on the same bullshit they mama was on. You can look at they mama and be like, where your daughter at? And you go follow them and you'll see another bitch getting down just like that. That's all I'm saying.
877-2.
That didn't answer my question, though.
We ain't gonna answer that. Oh, we got a phone call. We got Red Baron from Los Angeles on the phone. Red Baron.
Hey, see you, Tommy Quinn. What's going on, guys?
What's up,
hey,
man?
What's up,
Red Baron? Hey. How's Snoopy and all them?
Nah. Hey, I got two of them. You know, it just seems like when you reach a certain comfort level, then that means that the you know, the magic or whatever, the cuteness is gone. So,
right.
So a woman is like we said before, when she's on her period and she still lets you hit, I mean, that's a pretty good sign right there that she feels comfortable or you're not that cute to her anymore. She and for me personally.
Why are you so nervous, nigga? Get in and say what you're going to say. Nigga.
It's when I'm
police behind you.
She sees my dick and it's not on her heart for the first time. That means that I'm comfortable enough with her that I guess
what?
I'm just, you know, naked.
What's
and
he
not
saying?
Erection yeah. problems ain't got nothing
hey,
to do with that.
You need a blue pill in your life, pimp. All right,
hey,
we got to take a quick
is.
Break. Hold on, hold that thought, Ron. We got to take a quick break. My man Kev in the house who I ball with.
Detroit.
What's up?
He's 35 years old, getting into the rap game just now. He ain't got no criminal record or nothing. What's this song we about to hear,
he ain't
dog?
Never been shot or nothing.
This right here? Nah, this right here is Blowing Nails. The track I recorded right here is a Blowing Nails, you know what I'm saying?
What is Blowing Nails?
Blowing Nails, like, you know, smoking weed, however you call it.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah. Check it out.
You from the 70s, nigga. We ain't said lovely in a long time. Hit that for me, dog.
He said you from the 70s.
Check it out.
Blowing Nails.
Oh, we back. Speedy's coming to corner and I be
Speedy.
What the fuck?
Nigga, you
right
called
here.
Us
I'm
on
right
guard.
Here, man. I'm right here.
Nigga, y'all going to get fired.
I'm right
my
here.
My bad. I'm waiting, reading the Twitter.
Hey, I said
Twitter.
Donald Caldwell. That's
I will
hysterical.
Fire your Twitter ass. This motherfucker.
Twitter.
Kev, that was Kev's song y'all heard last. My man out of Detroit City.
Blowing
tell them all
L's.
About the song, man.
Hot.
Blowing Nails, that's just a chill vibe for all the weed smokers. You know, it's just a chill vibe. You know, it kind of intertwines just a chill vibe of smoking and, you know, a relationship going crazy.
Now, I'm going
to
tell you this.
Pay attention to it.
If a girl break out a blunt in my house, it's over.
Why?
Cigarette.
Oh, no, you can't smoke
Kev, do rappers go to school to say you know four times after
can
they
I finish
say
Speedy, if motherfucking Halle Berry rolled up a blunt that was laced
in your bed,
you would let her shit on your jaw.
On your jaw. So, Kev, tell them how to get in touch with you, man.
Sure. You can catch that track and along with other tracks at MrTate.com/MySpace. Also, you can check me out on Facebook, Kevin Tate.
You know?
Thank you, man, for hanging out with us, man. Appreciate that, dog.
Definitely.
We got, get my man Roy in there. All right, we got on the phone. We got Tay on the phone. Tay, where you at?
Hey, Tay.
Where you calling from, Arkansas? Yeah, Arkansas.
Please let this be a woman.
Trey?
Hey, Trey.
What's up, Trey?
Oh, okay. Yeah. Hey.
Nigga name.
Man, what's up? Yeah, man. I appreciate that rap, man. That was pretty tight, so.
Yeah. Yeah, my man said that was tight.
Got some love, Cam. Yeah.
I just want to let you know that I got that beat, too, on my Casio keyboard. Though,
so. Hilarious.
Oh, wow.
Oh, he's trying to crack, Cam.
Right after Jingle Bells.
He said he got that beat on his what now?
Casio.
His Casio keyboard.
All right, go ahead, dog.
Go ahead with your little what song.
When is the cuteness? When is the... when is the cuteness?
Is cold.
He got a little soft name.
All right. You got this. You know, you got a girl... You know, you pretty much meet her and she's fine. You pretty much do everything you can for the girl, buy her flowers, take her out. I mean, you try to be a good nigga to this girl.
Right. I like that.
You know, you get to this point, you know, you realize you're trying to do this stuff to keep her, and then she come up and tell you, you know, shoot, I can get any nigga to do this for me. Yeah. You know, she had like a D. She had like a D, but she pretty much don't appreciate you. She just wants you for what you got. You know, that's, you know, for me.
Now, are you finding this? Are you finding this out in the beginning or after you hit?
You need to choke her.
Oh, I'll find it out after I hit it. You know, I mean, I ain't got no problem hitting. I hit it all day long. But yeah, I mean, you pretty much find it out after you hit it. And
you find out a girl doesn't
appreciate you. No matter how good it is, how fine she is, you know, she thinks she all that. And she can, you know, get somebody like you anywhere. She that's it right there. You know, it's just
you sound like you've been.
I don't matter how fine you are.
No, but you know what?
This is what it is, man.
This is why the government makes the child support system and other ways to get money out of men. I'm about to tell you how it goes. Women will sell out anybody for money. Diamonds are a girl's best friend. Whoever paying the hoe, that's who she gonna have loyalty to.
But what does that have to do with?
I'm just saying, whoever's paying her.
True that.
But whoever gonna give her some money, that's who she gonna be up under smiling. Hey,
so she
gonna hang in there.
I know niggas who got money and they look like goddamn aliens.
Right.
But they be fucking some bad bitches.
They do.
It's not a coincidence.
This is true.
So you need some money, is what you're saying.
I know a nigga make Shabba Ranks look handsome than a motherfucker. This nigga keep bad bitches with him. He got that money. It's not a coincidence.
Ronnie Ranks.
So that nigga be like, show me a bitch I can't get. I be like, I can't because I know he got enough money to get whoever he want to get.
Now, how is that?
Well, we lose the phone. Don't do that. All right, on the phone out of San Diego.
Damn.
Because Shania go in a whole other direction.
Family.
No, you're not.
Piss on that carpet.
Don't put no mayonnaise on
that. Right, don't put. I got to leave you.
I kind of
just
Diego,
don't like when you start drinking from the carton. You know, get bring your own shit. I don't know. It's just
you know what? Diamond D, I don't think you should have anything to say what you don't like because your bar is pretty low.
I mean, nigga choking you and you still with it.
I don't like a nigga with daddy issues, you know?
Please, but you can choke you. I hate my kids,
but... No, he can't choke me,
Lewis. Can I get
choking is better than smiling with a motherfucker and never telling the truth ever. Some motherfucking bitches been around a nigga that ain't never told them, okay, yeah, this is what I did, for real.
I never got
the truth out of the nigga that
out of San Diego, we got LaShawn on the phone. LaShawn, are you there?
Hey, guys.
Out of this forever.
Hey, LaShawn.
Hey. Okay, for me, what's not cute, but when the cuteness wears off, I meet a guy, and very soon, they'd be on the I love you tip, and that doesn't work.
Ooh. What's she saying?
You know what? Just be glad you be in love, you little stuck up something.
Hey, Lewis.
I learned to appreciate
people loving her.
No, LaShawn.
Because it's fake. That shit is, I love you.
You go out with somebody and the girl tell me she loved me, I'm pretty much not going to fuck with her no more.
Because they think that's what you want to hear. That guys think that's what girls want to hear. I love you.
No, guys don't waste their I love you.
Maybe
say it
really
with
just
me.
Said
love
that though.
Well, hold on. LaShawn, what do you look like, baby? What do you look like? What do you look like, baby?
I like him.
Light skin. See what she said?
That's all she
had to
say. Weirdo.
Light skin. That makes me cute because I'm light skin.
Hold on.
Is she?
Are you
might look like Frankenberry.
Can I find out?
Count Chocula.
Frankenberry light skin.
I think you said Franken.
Hold on. Light skin.
Lady Eloise.
What is your size, sweetheart?
What is my size? I'm sorry? Yeah.
Exactly.
A 3T?
You said what is my sign?
Size.
Your size.
You
know
what he said. 5'4", 123. What is your size?
I can't hear you. You said size?
She heard you. She just building up the courage.
Move your helmet off your ears.
What team do you wear?
Do you have to have the fan on while you sleep?
Nah.
Okay, cool.
I'm a size 9.
Oh, that's cool. That's perfect.
What does that
I'm
mean?
Big. I got a big girl.
That's what she said. She's 19.
She's Lane Bryant.
That's Lane Bryant. That's
she getting there.
She getting there.
She getting there.
Okay. 19.
One store over. She ain't in Forever 21.
Okay.
Lane Bryant.
But that's cute, though. I like
when niggas ask you to the movies, do they be like, you got your way in?
Hilarious.
She's cute, though. She likes
skin. Every time I do go out, I make sure I have money to take care of my own. So that way they don't have nothing to
say. That's right.
You know, I can have them my own. That's what a real woman's supposed to do, you know?
I hate when you pick a fight with a girl at the movie and then you got to drop her off.
Thank you for the phone call, baby girl. Okay, out of Oklahoma, we got Future on the phone. Future.
Future,
where are you?
What up?
What's up, dog?
What's your real name?
Oh, man, it ain't nothing, Speedy. What up, Corey?
What up, man?
Man, you the realest nigga on the air, man.
I try to be, man. I try. I don't want no trouble, man.
Why don't you be up, real? Ladies? What's your name?
About y'all leaving. What's up?
Ladies.
About hey, hey, what's up?
Oh, so you get your dismantled future.
That shit pretty much plays out, man. I call them bone collectors.
Hey,
man.
You going to say hello to everybody but me, you little boy. I'm going to knock you back into the future.
Wow.
Back that was hard, future. Wasn't it?
That was original.
That's insecurity, Louis. Okay. You want a digger to speak to you.
Oh. Hi, Louis. Yeah. Hi, Louis. I wear my best thong and everything.
That's what my daddy used to do when he come see my mom.
All right, Future, what's your comment?
He wouldn't say shit to me.
He wouldn't say shit. My stepdaddy did the same thing.
Busted nothing, leave ass nigga.
Shut up. Future, what's your comment?
Go ahead, dog.
Hey, that's pretty much played out when you run into a bone collector. You know what I'm saying? You meet these ladies that, you know, they got every designer material, fabric, and jewelry that's imaginable, but they only get the shit on their birthdays and on Christmas. You know what I'm saying? And find out that she lived with her mom and three brothers and none of the shit she got, she accumulated on her own.
So what you saying, Future? As soon as you find that out, you ain't trying to be with it no more?
No. I mean, you know, she go out looking like, you know, like $1 million and like, you know, like she got it going on and independent, as they so call it. But, you know, really she dependent on other people to build her up. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I agree with
but,
you.
And that's fucked up that men pick.
Thank you for the phone
men
call.
Pick. Women of how they look instead of what's really going on with them.
Go ahead, Roy.
But why is that a problem? If a chick looked bad in public, but you know she broke down in private, you can use that shit as ammo in an argument. Like, she can't say shit to you ever.
Well, some girls are so vain, you can say that shit and it don't bother them, but until you say it around other people, because I bring a bitch down around
other
people.
So you got right, that's your goal?
Glory, you bring a girl down, though?
No, I'm just saying, like, it's shit you can
be holding. Have you ever
soaked a girl?
It's shit you can be holding in.
Feelings, I'm sure.
It's shit you can hold in to that big argument.
And what would you say, Corey?
All kinds of shit you can say. Right.
Like what?
Every nigga you fuck with hates you, bitch. Yeah, it don't sink in right away, but just think about that. Every nigga you fucked hates you. What the fuck? That's a lot of niggas for a lot of girls, too.
You know, in L.A., you know, the other one that cut deep in L.A. That's why you ain't never booked shit.
That's why you got to wait in line at the party, bitch.
You ain't never auditioned for nothing.
That's the one.
All right, that's fucked up about L.A. If you waiting in line at a party, it's something irregular about the way you look.
Hilarious.
You know I ain't lying about that.
You don't
that.
Fuck with irregular bitches?
I fuck with any bitch.
All right, we got a phone picky. Call. We got JR from Vegas.
Don't have any bitch up under me.
But. JR, Vegas, what's that?
What's going on?
What's that?
Hey, JR.
Oh, not much. Hey, what messed up for me is when she starts talking, you dog.
That's a
say it again.
When she starts stalking.
Oh, yeah. That's just... But this is after you hit it, though, right? Or are you talking about before?
Oh, yeah. After you hit it. I ran a decoy from a brother. When I was a girl, she had a friend or whatever. I'll never go out. For one, she was taller than me anyway. Anywho, my friend tell her...
Nigga's a hoblet. Hobbit.
her friend tell me, she always says she can't find nobody. So, I knock her down that night. She go to sleep. I leave her out.
supposed to.
My brother, me and my brother, we got a rule. Don't ask, don't tell. She calling him, asking me for my phone number, asking him for my phone number and everything. He ain't give it to her. Dog, my boss hit me on the shoulder one day and said, no, this girl been out standing outside this gate for a week. You know, came up every day at my job. Man, I had to duck out the back gate. But what got me when she showed up to my son's safe street, and she ain't got no kids that go to the school, that's a problem, dog.
So that means she ain't scared of you. If you have some bitches, hey, if a bitch ain't scared of you, that's always a problem.
So, Diamond, you definitely scared of dude.
Yes.
You wouldn't follow
Nigga,
him.
I'm scared of him. For her. Damn. Did I mention he's 6'9"? 6'9", 380.
Corey Holcomb, tell him what you're doing, dog. <Jericho. laughs> Oh, 6'9". Remember him?
Yeah. He was pitiful. Remember he came everywhere biblical was. He was like, yeah, he's like, hey, how you doing, man? He was a rapper, too.
Yeah, he wasn't. No, he's an R&B singer.
R&B singer? Yeah.
I thought he said he rapped. He said he was 6'9", a rapper.
Too. Right, that's what I thought.
He was R&B singer, trust me.
He was confused.
Wow. He heard the nigga sing?
He used to go to R&B, yeah.
He never made it, though, huh?
Nah.
A failed rapper is better than a failed R&B singer.
Did he get money from Vivica?
Corey, where are you going to be, dog?
I'm in L.A. this weekend, man. But I'll be in New York at Caroline's. We got the next. Get ready, motherfuckers. I'm cussing that pussy-ass town out.
So the 20th, though.
Yeah, the 20th. Whatever that weekend is.
June 20th. Yeah.
Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Yeah, I'm in San Francisco. Anyway, Lou Deasy, where are you going to be, dog?
Hey, I'm going to be at...
Sleep.
You know, I'm going to be at my son's...
Junior high?
No, my son has a game tomorrow at Burbank.
That's
good
what
luck.
I just said.
Hi, boys.
I'll tell you that. The motherfucker.
Hey, Louie, good luck. Out to my son. Hey, and all the parents whose kids are in sports, keep supporting them. They really love to watch
some of them kids.
What was that voice
them
you made down there?
That was him from...
he said, hi, boys.
That was him from... he's doing the voice from...
Family Guy.
Yeah, the old man with the two boys was arguing outside his house. Now, boys, y'all stop arguing and let's come in my house and play who could take the most Tylenol PM.
You know what he told me? He said, I like it when you ride your little bike and your pants fit loose and it just blow it all open.
That's sick, man.
The pervert-ass old man. That's hilarious. Fucking hilarious. Fuck that.
Ron G., tell me where you going to be at, dog.
This Friday, what's the spot called?
We're at Travis Air Force Base in Fairfield.
Okay, and then on Saturday, I'm hosting the Club Sushi on Sunset, 6374 Sunset Boulevard, 9:30 Saturday.
Club Sushi?
Yes.
All right.
Stinky pussy bitches or fish?
Both.
Oh. Right. Tell where you going to be, dog. What you doing?
I'll be...
Roy.
I'm off this week, man. Next week, Chicago Comedy Festival. RoyWoodJr.com for more info.
Tell them how to get your pranks.
It's all on the web. Just Google Roy Prank Calls Broke Ass Comic.
Now, who's the other dude on the CD?
I got a couple of the cats on there. It's Ricky like Smiley on there.
No, I know Ricky was on there.
Yeah, it's my homeboy. Hey, MJ boy.
No homo. No.
Anytime you say a homosexual day, that's the new shit on this show.
No homo.
Hey, boy.
It's terrible.
So who all you say you had on your CD?
So it's a little Ricky Smiley on
hey,
there.
Hey, boy.
No homo.
You got to be careful. Wow. You're a Q dog. Them niggas will come down
wow.
here.
Hey, boy.
No homo.
Nah. He from the crib, man. I can't even join in
on
that.
I know you said he from the crib, so that means you got his back and everything. But still, who you say on there?
No homo.
Ricky Smiley.
Hey, boy.
And who's like the other it. Guy? I guess like uncle somebody or who is it, your cousin or
never? Yeah. My little cousin's been on that cousin.
Do you hang around
no,
with
not you? The little dudes, there's another dude.
Jim J. Makeda.
Yeah, who is that?
Yeah, that's another comedian. This guy, Trey Williamson.
He be around Ricky?
Nah.
He be around who again?
He's around Ricky Smiley again? Who is it? Ricky Smiley.
Hey, boy.
Hey, Speedy, real quick. That shout out, Stevie. Stevie is get one for his black belt next week. Ashley, the intern's brother. So good luck to him.
There it is. Love for that.
Wow. I mean,
Diamond, tell him where you're going to be choked out next week.
What happened to kicking
this
people?
A boy?
What happened to pushing a motherfucker?
Hey.
Kicking is
or
so much more
hair.
Technical.
Didn't they used to be when they grab your hair and pull you out of a spot? What happened to
all right,
that?
Here we got to go. Here, where are we going
to be? Who the fuck are you going
to be? I am actually going to be getting my son's birthday is in a few days, so I'm going to be getting that together. And but anybody who wants to... contact me, of course. It's myspace.com, Diamond Dawn Cook. Just don't everybody contact me about the choking thing. Because I'm over it.
It's too late. Over
Stevie, it. Keep working hard, Stevie. Ashley's proud of you.
Okay, and Shanae.
Hey.
Yes.
First off, I want to say congratulations. Miracle, our producer here, her daughter graduated from kindergarten today.
Aww.
That's beautiful.
And she got got left back like four times. I'm so proud of you.
Is that all because it really happened or that was a joke?
That was that look like. I saw her heart.
That coloring is fucked up.
Hey, Ricky Smiley. Hey, boy.
No homo.
Rick, if you're listening, I love you. I got your back.
Hey, boy.
No homo.
I got to go back to Birmingham and deal
with
this.
Tell me where you're going to be.
Of course, I'm going to be at the Lakers game coming up. But also, Twitter, you want to go to Twitter, Foxhole, or is it Twitter, right?
Foxhole. And then also,
and then also remember, hit us up on our website. Go check it out. We're going to have the pictures from today. We got a little bit of videos from today's show. Backstage stuff that you guys don't get to see anywhere else on the internet, www.speediescomedycorner.com. Just how it sounds.
They don't use the W no more. TDP!
June 28th, BET Awards. Jamie Foxx is the host. Make sure you check that out.
Hey, Speedy.
The show will be on the red carpet.
Ricky Smiley, manager. What's his name? He used to manage them all.
Hey, boys.
Right. It's your boy Speedy in the house. I want to thank everybody for calling.
Damn.
We learned a lot tonight. What Ricky and his manager be doing in the green room before the show?
I don't know.
No homo.
We love doing the show. Give it up for Miracle in the House. My man James making it happen. My son's here. My daughter's in town, so we're going to have a good time when her birthday's next year.
Shout out to all the Geminis.
Yeah.
Cheyenne, Daddy loves you.
If you live up in Oakland, you come check out me, Ron G, and my man Dante. We're doing a show at the Air Force Base. It's going to be off the chain. Hit me up on MySpace. Speedy is funny. That's Speedy IZ funny.
Impossible.
It's been off the chain. Love everybody here. Thank you for coming
boys.
Out. All the special guests that came out. And shout out to Ricky Smiley.
Hey, boys. No homo.
Hey, Speedy's comedy corner. And I'll be
Speedy.
Up in this.
Bitch.
Shout out to Go.
Ricky Smiley's farts sound like this.